Now, in this session, we are going to see the construction and working of a CO2 laser. Carbon dioxide laser was developed by C.K. and Patil in the year 1963. A carbon dioxide molecule has two oxygen atoms between which there is a carbon atom. It has three different modes of vibration which are as follows. First, we are going to see about the symmetric stretching mode. In this mode, carbon atom is stationary and the two oxygen atoms either move towards or away from the carbon atom simultaneously along the molecular axis. Now, what is a molecular axis? You can see in the figure here, the carbon atom is at the center and the two oxygen atoms are lying right and left of the carbon atom. The axis through which all the three are aligning, it is called as a molecular axis. In a symmetric stretching mode, the carbon atom is fixed and the two oxygen atoms either move towards the carbon atom or move away from the carbon atom. That means the carbon atom is stationary and the two oxygen atoms either move towards or away from the carbon atom simultaneously along the molecular axis. This is called as a symmetric stretching mode. Next is asymmetric stretching mode. In this mode, all the three atoms oscillate along the molecular axis, but two oxygen atoms move in one direction while the carbon atom moves in the opposite direction. Now, if you look at the figure in the asymmetric stretching mode, carbon atom is at the center and the two oxygen atoms are right and left of the carbon atom. In asymmetric mode, carbon atom is moving towards my left and the two oxygen atoms are moving towards my right. That means the directions of the carbon and the oxygen atoms are opposite to each other, but two oxygen atoms are moving in the same direction, but the carbon atom is moving opposite to the direction of the oxygen atom. So this is called as an asymmetric stretching mode. Next is a bending mode. In this mode, all the three atoms oscillate normal to the molecular axis. That is, two oxygen atoms pull together in positive y-axis and the carbon atom is moving in the direction opposite to that of oxygen atoms. If you look at the figure here, the carbon atom is at the center and it is moving towards the positive y-axis, perpendicular to the molecular axis, whereas oxygen atoms are moving to the negative y direction, which is opposite to that of the carbon atom. Here all the three atoms are moving perpendicular to the molecular axis. So these are the three types of vibrations, that is symmetric mode, asymmetric mode and bending modes. Next, we start with the construction of a CO2 laser. CO2 laser consists of a discharge tube having a diameter of 2.5 centimeters and the length of about 5 meters. And the tube is water cooled. Why it is water cooled? Because a lot of heat has been generated because of the transitions. To reduce the heat, the water is being cooled so that discharge tube will be at a lower temperature. Next, the discharge tube is filled with a mixture of carbon dioxide, nitrogen and helium gases in the ratio of 1:2:3, with traces of hydrogen or water vapor. Now here, the discharge tube is filled with the carbon dioxide, nitrogen and helium gases. Now here, the active medium is nothing but the carbon dioxide, nitrogen and helium gases. This is called as the active medium. Since we have discussed in the previous sessions that what are the requisites and conditions are lasing action. So the active medium has been satisfied and the transitions are going to happen in the carbon dioxide, nitrogen and helium gases in the ratio of 1:2:3. Next, the tube is two electrodes connected to a power supply. The tube has two electrodes connected to a power supply, which helps in the electrical pumping, because the source of energy which we are doing to raise the atoms to higher energy state is nothing but the electrical power supply. So the pumping is nothing but the electrical pumping, and it is being done by supplying the electrical energy. Next, Brewster's windows. Brewster's windows are sealed to the tube at both the ends to give a polarized output. Two plane mirrors, one is fully silvered and the other one is half silvered, are fixed on either side of the tube normal to its axis. There is 100% reflectivity from the fully silvered mirror and polarized laser light comes out from the half silvered mirror. Now if you see, look at the figure here, a discharge tube and the electrodes are placed here with a high power supply, which acts like a pumping. Discharge tube is given there. Towards the right is partially reflecting mirror through which the laser light is being seen, and towards the left is fully reflecting mirror. Fully reflecting mirror reflects the light which has fallen on it 100% without any absorption. And in the passes of reflecting back, the Brewster's windows are placed so that the plane polarized output is being given out from the laser light, from the partially reflecting mirror. Here, the active medium is a mixture of gases of carbon dioxide, nitrogen and helium. And reflecting surfaces, that is reflecting mirrors, act as a medium or laser cavities. And pumping is done by the high voltage source. So, all the three conditions are been satisfied. Now, we are going to start with the working of a CO2 laser. This is an energy level diagram of a CO2 laser. Now, what is the working? Here, the high voltage source which has been given across the electrodes excites the gas molecule. So, what is happening here is the high voltage across the electrodes excites the gas molecule. That means the pumping is being done. The nitrogen molecules in the gas are excited to a higher levels and collide with the CO2 molecule in the ground state. Because of matching of energy level, resonant transfer of energy takes place from nitrogen to carbon dioxide molecule. As a result, CO2 molecules are excited to metastable state. Now, if you look at the energy level diagrams here, nitrogen gas, which is at the ground state, due to excitation by electrical discharge, the atoms of nitrogen, which are less in mass, move to a excited state by the excitation of electrical discharge and goes to a metastable state of nitrogen atoms. Now, the E5 state of CO2 molecule is at the level of metastable state of a nitrogen atom. Now, if you look at the figure here, the metastable state and the E5 state of CO2 molecule, which is also a metastable state, both are at the same level. Due to matching of energy levels, there is a energy transfer by collision. This is called as a resonance. That means at resonance, maximum energy transfer happens by the collisions. And what is happening here is nitrogen atoms collides with the CO2 atoms. Thereby, CO2 atoms are brought to a E5 state of CO2 molecule. And the nitrogen atoms which are at metastable state come down. That means the collision is happening between the nitrogen atoms at the metastable state and the CO2 atoms in the ground state. Thereby, due to collision energy transfer, the atoms in the CO2 molecule atoms are brought to the E5 state, which is nothing but a metastable state of a CO2 atom. So, what is happening in between? Since it is a metastable state of a CO2 molecule or an atom, what exactly is happening is population inversion has been achieved. Since it is a metastable state, some of the atoms are sitting there for a short period of time, due to which population inversion of E5 state has been achieved by the pumping. Now, what is happening here? Since E5 is a metastable state, the transitions from the metastable state, that is E4 to E3, leads to 10.6 micrometers for E4 energy state, and the transitions from E5 to E3 leads to 9.6 micrometers. You can see here. Here population inversion takes place with respect to E3 and E4. Transitions from E5 to E4 gives rise to radiation of wavelength 10.6 micrometers, and the transitions from E5 to E3 level gives rise to radiation of wavelength 9.6 micrometers. Other transitions E3 and E2, E4 to E2, E3 to E2 are inelastic collision. Now, if you look at the figure here, the transitions, it is a single arrowed, you can see from transitions from E3 to E2 are dotted arrows, and the transition from E4 to E2 are also dotted arrows, and the transitions from E2 to E1 state, the ground state of CO2, is also a dotted line, which indicates inelastic collisions. Now, here what is happening here is, when the atoms from the E3 state and E4 state are coming to E2 state, the helium atoms which we are having, because we are have discharge tube contains helium gas also, the helium gas which are sitting at E2 level, the moment the atoms comes from E4 and E3 levels to E2 state, the helium atoms collides with the atoms at the E2 level of CO2 atoms, thereby CO2 molecules are brought back to the ground state instead of accumulating in E2 state. So helium atom is attacking the atoms which are coming from E3 and E4 to the energy levels, thereby atoms of CO2 are brought to the ground state. This is how CO2 laser is high power laser producing few kilowatts in continuous mode, and it has 30% more efficient than the other laser. This is the working of a CO2 laser. Thank you.